A very good morning and gentlemen children. Welcome to your physics class. Children, we were doing the chapter Garbage In, Garbage Out. So please be ready with your science book and pencil. We'll continue with this chapter and we'll continue with our next topic of this chapter that is very, very, very important. And today we'll learn about how we can manage the waste, or we will talk about waste management. So there are n number of waste products that are releasing from every houses, every factories and every industry, and they are dumped at some place or the other and causing environmental pollution. So this we have discussed about this in the previous class. We have also talked about what are the landfills, what are the procedure which is done to prepare a landfill, and after landfill what happens to the garbage. And we have also studied what is garbage. Alright, so I hope this much topic is clear to you. So now today we'll start with a new topic of this chapter, that is reusing and recycling of waste. Okay, before that children, let me recall you the types of waste. So children, we have talked about two different types of waste. So what are the two different types of waste? So the two different types of waste are biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste. What are biodegradable waste? The waste that can again be used and that can be degraded and can be mixed in soil and can again be used. Alright, that is biodegradable. What are non-biodegradable? Those waste that cannot be broken into smaller pieces and cannot be further used, which remains as it is for a longer and longer period of time. So those waste are called non-biodegradable waste. Clear? So the example of non-biodegradable waste was plastic, and the examples of biodegradable waste are many, like papers, vegetables, everything, they are biodegradable waste. So we have talked about all these things in the previous class. Today we'll start with how we can manage this waste. So if we are dumping the huge amount of waste into the landfills and to the various places and it is causing environmental pollution, what is our responsibility as a human, as a citizen of India? What is our responsibility to manage this waste? How we can reduce these waste and further use it? Alright, so today we'll start with this topic. So recycling and reusing of waste. Children, this topic is also named as waste management sometimes. So don't get confused if any question comes to you as waste management. The same as with this. Alright, so please children, open your book. Open this chapter. Garbage in, garbage out. We'll start with the topic, that is reusing and recycling of waste. So I'm going to share the PPT first, then we'll start with the chapter. Okay, so let's start with it. So children, our topic is reusing and recycling of waste. So under this topic, we are going to study these subheadings. First is segregation of waste. Second is recycling biodegradable waste, reusing and recycling paper, reusing and recycling non-biodegradable waste, and disposal of plastics. Children, these topics are very, very, very important. So let's first start with few important things. First, children, we'll discuss about all these points in a brief. I'll just introduce you with these topics and then we'll go to the book. Okay, so segregation of waste. What is segregation? Segregate karne ka matlab hota hai separate karna. Either use the term segregation or use the term separate. So children, if you remember when we were talking about landfills, then what we used to do is we used to separate the useful product and non-useful product, isn't it? So segregation is separation of useful products and non-useful products, or biodegradable substances and non-biodegradable waste. We separate it out. We'll see how we do it. Then talking about recycling biodegradable waste. Children, before discussing this recycling biodegradable waste, I just want to introduce with you with three terms, that is 3 R's of waste management. So the 3 R's of waste management are reduce, reuse and recycle. These are the 3 R's of waste management. मतलब ये तीन बहुत important rule है कैसे हम waste को control कर सकते हैं, कैसे हम waste को ज़्यादा वेस्ट ना हो इसको कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं या एनवायरमेंटल पोल्यूशन को हम कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं. तो दीज आर द 3 बेसिक रूल्स ऑफ मेंटेनिंग द और रिड्यूसिंग द वेस्ट. सो फर्स्ट इज रिड्यूस. रिड्यूस का मतलब क्या होता है बेटा? रिड्यूस का मतलब होता है कम यूज करना. रिड्यूस इज कम यूज करना. हम लोग कहते हैं ना किसी चीज को रिड्यूस कर दो. रिड्यूस करने का मतलब उसको कम कर दो. गॉट इट? So reduce, buy less, buy products that use less packaging or that last longer. हमें packaged materials कम use करने चाहिए, जैसे कि chips में plastic wrappers होते हैं, we take various namkeens उसमें plastic wrappers होते हैं, toffee में plastic wrappers होते हैं, chocolates में plastic wrappers होते हैं. So we should consume it less, we should buy these products less rather than buying something which is covered with a paper material. Or in fact we should reduce the use of plastic. जब हम market में जाते हैं तो हमें कोई चीज़ अगर plastic में मिल रही है, like take consider if you are going to purchase a vegetable and the shopkeeper or the vegetable seller is giving you the vegetable in plastic bag, or you are going to any shop and shopkeeper is giving you something in a plastic bag, ask that person not to give. Okay? Ask them to keep a paper bag and take paper bag from them. Got it? So we should buy less such products. We should buy less products of plastics and less products of packaging material. Got it? So, and this is the one condition. Second condition is that packaging materials वो जल्दी खराब हो जाते हैं. जितने भी पैकेज मटेरियल्स होते हैं वो जल्दी खराब हो जाते हैं, इसलिए हमें उनको कम यूज करना चाहिए. नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू रीयूज. रीयूज का मतलब होता है दोबारा यूज करना. रीयूज इज यूजिंग इट अगेन. ओके? सो बाय रीयूजेबल प्रोडक्ट. सो वी शुड बाय रीयूजेबल प्रोडक्ट जिसको हम दोबारा से यूज कर सकें. ठीक है? तो वी शुड ऑलवेज बाय सच प्रोडक्ट्स लाइक rechargeable or refillable things. Like take for example, if you are purchasing a sanitizer or if you are purchasing a hand wash. Okay, so hand wash you take it in a plastic bottle, isn't it? So if there is a plastic bottle in the hand wash, next time don't go and again purchase the plastic bottle. What you can do is rather you can purchase a refill. एक रिफिल भी आता है उसका. आप मार्केट में जाइए, आप रिफिल परचेज करिए और वापस से उसको भर दीजिए. डोंट गो इन टू मार्केट एंड परचेज अगेन एंड अगेन दैट प्लास्टिक बॉटल. ओके? दिस इज द रीयूज. ओके? और यू कैन ऑल्सो डू इट लाइक दैट इफ यू आर हैविंग अ न्यूज़पेपर एट होम एंड दैट न्यूज़पेपर इज नाउ वेस्ट. ठीक है? हमने एक दिन पढ़ा, आज का न्यूज़पेपर आया, फिर अगले दिन वो खराब हो जाता है. What we can do is, we can use it in the kitchen or you can use it to cover your books. Okay? So that is reuse of the material. Okay? So we should focus on reusing such materials, or even you can make some crafts out of that paper. Okay? So you make a craft out of your paper and just put your small things in that. Okay? So we should focus on such things. Okay? Next we have is recycle. Children, this is important. Now try to understand this recycle. Recycle and reusing are two different things. Reuse में हम क्या करते हैं? जो चीज जैसी है उसको हम दोबारा वैसे यूज करते हैं. Recycle में हम क्या करते हैं कि कोई चीज अगर हमारे पास है उसको हम प्रोसेस्ड करेंगे, उसको हम दूसरी चीज में कन्वर्ट करके और फिर यूज कर रहे हैं, उसको हम बोलते हैं रिसाइकिल. गॉट इट? So recycle is reusing materials or recovering valuable materials from waste or scrap. अगर consider we have a newspaper again, newspaper को अगर हमने as it is किसी चीज के लिए use कर दिया, तो that is reuse. जैसे take for in kitchen, if we are cooking some oily things like pakodi or something like that, what we can do is, we can rather than using the tissue paper or something like that, what we can do is, we can put the newspaper, and to soak the oil, we can just put the newspaper and we can take it out the oily substance or oily food. Alright, so that is reuse. Okay, recycle is what? We are torn the newspaper, then we are converting it into some other product. That is recycle. Okay, so this is reuse and recycle. These are the 3 R's of waste management, or 3 R's of reducing the solid waste. Got it? Now coming back to our topic that was given in the book. So these are the 5 different subheadings under this heading, that is reusing and recycling of waste. So coming on to the first, that is segregation of waste. So what is segregation of waste, children? Nowadays, if you go out or if you go in a park or somewhere, you can see 2 different types of dustbins kept there. Rather, government has passed different colored dustbins for different products. Like we have yellow or blue dustbin for paper. We have green colored dustbin for glasses and bottles. We have yellow dustbin for plastics. We have red for metals. So these are different colored dustbins. Nowadays it is under use. This is a method to segregate the waste. Hame isme kya karna hai? Humne isme waste ko segregate kar diya. Or rather, what we can do is, we can take 2 dustbin. Ek mein humne biodegradable waste dale, aur dusre mein humne non-biodegradable waste dale, as it is given in your book. So, let me share the book first. So, children, see this first figure in the first page of your chapter. So you can see here we have 2 dustbins. Alright, one is of green color, another is of blue color. So green color is for biodegradable waste and blue is for non-biodegradable waste. So we should dump the things accordingly. Like if we have a newspaper or we have a wrapper or something like that, we should put it in a vegetables or food items, we should put it in a biodegradable waste. If we have any plastic material or plastic cans or glass bottle, we should put it in a non-biodegradable material. So for this, we should know what is difference between biodegradable and non-biodegradable. And I hope you are now pretty much sure about it. So children, please teach others also. Okay? आप ये दूसरों को भी सिखा सकते हैं कि हमें ये चीज ऐसे करनी चाहिए. Okay, that's good thing. That is awareness. Okay, got it? Now coming back to this. So I hope you got it. So this is segregation of waste. So we have different color dustbins to separate the content. Got it? So now coming back to the text, let's see what is written. Children, please open this page. Please open this page, children. Okay, so let's start with it. So we have done this first page. We have completed this first page. Now coming on to reusing and recycling waste. So let's see. One way of reducing the amount of waste to be thrown away is to reuse whatever can be used again. जिसको हम दोबारा use कर सकते हैं, हमें उसको दोबारा use करना चाहिए. Another is to recycle it. हमें उसको दोबारा recycle करके भी हम use कर सकते हैं, right? What is recycling? Recycling involves collecting waste material and processing them to make new products. हमने waste material को collect किया, उसको process किया, मतलब हमने उसपे कोई changes किए, या तो हमने उसको torch किया, उसको wet कर दिया, और उसको हमने किसी और चीज में convert कर दिया into a new product. So that is recycling. Okay? Like for example, if you take a glass, ठीक है? हम क्या कर सकते हैं? Consider अगर आपका glass है, कोई glass की glass made tumbler है, वो टूट गया. What we can do is we can melt it and we can mold it into another showpiece kind of thing. So that is recycling. Got it? So this is reuse and recycling.
Both reusing and recycling reduces the amount of waste thrown into the community dustbin and therefore makes the environment cleaner. तो जितना हम उसको रिसाइकिल और यूज करेंगे उतनी कम चीजें हम वेस्ट या डस्टबिन में डालेंगे और वो एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन को कंट्रोल करेगा. गॉट इट? सो फर्स्ट वी हैव सेग्रीगेशन ऑफ वेस्ट. सो द टू काइंड्स ऑफ वेस्ट रिक्वायर डिफरेंट मेथड्स ऑफ डिस्पोजल. देयरफॉर द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज टू segregate the waste into biodegradable and non-biodegradable. So first what we can do is we can separate the waste into biodegradable and non-biodegradable. That I have told you earlier ki biodegradable ko hum alag kar lenge, non-biodegradable ko hum alag kar lenge, or we can use a different color dustbins to put different items. Got it? Every household should have two garbage bin. One for biodegradable waste and other for non-biodegradable waste. Ideally, there should be third bin for toxic. Toxic is poisonous thing like medicines, batteries, dry paints and dry shoe polish. So, medicines वगैरह के लिए we should keep another dustbin. Logically, it should be there. So, we should keep three types of dustbin at our home also, like biodegradable, non-biodegradable and toxic. So in biodegradable we can dump the vegetables, waste vegetables and peel of vegetable, paper, we can dump all these things in a biodegradable dustbin. And in non-biodegradable dustbin what we can put is, we can put glasses, we can put plastic material, wrappers, chips wrapper and everything we can dump in another dustbin. Okay children, this you can follow it at your home also. And we should keep one small dustbin to just dump the waste such as medicine, batteries, paints, etc. Got it? So these are toxic materials. So this is the one method to reduce and recycling the waste material. So this is the reducing material basically. Now coming on to the very important topic of this chapter, that is recycling biodegradable waste. How we can recycle the biodegradable waste, how we can reuse and we can convert it into another thing. So for this, a very important thing is composting. So what is compost? How we form the compost? What is vermicomposting? This we are going to study now. Okay, so let's start with it. So this is children very 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 important topic. Please pay attention, those who are still sleeping and whatever, if you are not paying attention children, please pay attention to this topic. This is very 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 important topic of this chapter, that is recycling biodegradable waste. So children, now we are pretty much sure what is biodegradable waste. So jitne bhi vegetables hain, jitne bhi छिलके हैं वेजिटेबल के, या जितने भी लिविंग मटेरियल से हमें चीज़ें पास मिलती हैं, जैसे कि एग हो गया या चिकन हो गया या मीट हो गया या फ्लैश हो गया, जितनी भी चीज़ें हमें लिविंग मटेरियल से मिलती हैं, चाहे वो वेजिटेबल्स हो, चाहे वो कोई भी प्लांट्स हो, चाहे वो फ्रूट्स हो, चाहे वो चिकन हो या एग हो या कोई भी ऐसे प्रोडक्ट जो कि हमें एनिमल से मिलते हैं, वो बायोडिग्रेडेबल वेस्ट में आते हैं. ठीक. So what is compost? So what we are doing is, first we'll talk about compost. It is a natural process that recycles the nutrient in the waste to yield manure or compost. So basically we are here talking about composting. So composting is a natural process. Okay. So is process mein hum kya karte hain? What we do, we take the vegetables and raw vegetables jo ki humne dump kiya hai. बेसिकली यू कैन फाइंड इट इन योर किचन डस्टबिन. किचन डस्टबिन में जब आप देखेंगे तो उसमें सारे बायोडिग्रेडेबल वेस्ट ही डंप किए जाते हैं बेसिकली. सो वॉट यू कैन डू इज यू कैन टेक दैट मटेरियल दैट इज केप्ट इन द डस्टबिन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सेपरेट इट आउट इफ देयर इज एनी प्लास्टिक मटेरियल और समथिंग लाइक दैट, जस्ट रिमूव इट फ्रॉम देयर. नाउ देन आफ्टर वॉट यू कैन डू इज, लेट्स सी वॉट वी कैन डू हियर. वी हैव अ स्टेप्स टू form a compost. So let's see. So step one is how we can prepare a compost is, first is just dig a pit
हम क्या करते हैं, सॉयल में पिट डिक करते हैं, हम गड्ढा करते हैं और उसमें हम जितने भी रॉ वेजिटेबल्स हैं या रॉटन वेजिटेबल्स हैं उसको डंप कर देते हैं और उसके ऊपर फिर से सॉइल की लेयर चढ़ा देंगे, ठीक है। तो दिस इज फर्स्ट स्टेप। सेकेंड स्टेप इज विल कीप इट फॉर, सेकेंड स्टेप वी हैव इज वी विल कीप इट फॉर सम टाइम फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 30 डेज, ठीक है। तो सॉइल में वी नो देयर आर वेरियस बैक्टीरियाज दैट विल ब्रेक डाउन दीज rotten vegetables into smaller pieces and will convert it and take out the nutrient from it and will convert it into the compost. All right. Now this is also called children manure. What is manure? Manure वो soil content होता है that is highly rich in the nutrient. जो कि nutrient में बहुत rich होता है. Manure को हम हिंदी बोलते हैं खाद, ठीक है। तो जो भी nutrient या manure होता है that is very 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 rich in all the nutrients, got it? So now we have several steps. Okay, so these are the steps to form a compost. So first step is we have a fresh vegetables that we have brought from the market. Okay, now after some time what happens, it gets rotten or we just peel off the peel from the vegetables and we dump it in a dustbin. ठीक है, जितने भी हमारे पास vegetables खराब हो गए हैं या जितने भी हमारे peel हैं, take the peel of banana or something, we just dump it in a dustbin, got it? After dumping it in a dustbin, first you should take out if there is some non-biodegradable waste, just take it out from that and create a pit in the soil and bury all the vegetables, all the raw vegetables in the soil, got it? Now cover that again with the soil. Soil se humne usko cover kar liya and we'll keep it for 30 odd days and just keep on mixing the soil. जहाँ पे आपने इसको क्या छोड़ा है वहाँ पे आप उसको top and toss कर सकते हैं. तो top after topping and tossing the soil, what you can do is you just keep it for some time. Keep it for almost 25 to 30 days. So what you will form after this, this will generate, the soil will convert it into such type of material and then we have after 30 days formation of compost. Okay, now after this compost is formed, what you can do is you can again grow the vegetables and crops in that compost and you will again get the fresh vegetables. So I think this is a very good process to recycle all these waste and vegetables rather than dumping it into a dustbin and keeping it to the collector that comes to your house. It is the best procedure. Even you can do it in your kitchen garden or if you have a garden, you can do it there. I think most of you, those who are having a garden, this procedure is followed, and if it is followed, it is very good. And children, if you are having a garden at your home or if you are having or somewhere where you are, even you can do this in आपके पास गमले होते हैं, आप ये काम अपने गमले में भी कर सकते हैं. सो दिस इज वेरी 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 एफिशिएंट मेथड टू रिड्यूस पोल्यूशन. दिस यू कैन डू इट एट योर होम एनी टाइम. ओके, दिस विल टेक हार्डली 30 डेज और अ मंथ टू फॉर्म अ कंपोस्ट. ओके, सो दिस इज द मेथड ऑफ फॉर्मिंग कंपोस्ट. यू कैन डू इट एट योर होम. यू कैन आस्क योर पेरेंट्स टू डू इट फॉर यू. टेक द हेल्प फ्रॉम देम. नॉट नेसेसरली, don't pressurize, you can, but if you are interested you can do it. Okay, so this was about composting. Okay, so this was the method which we use for composting. Let's see what is written in the chapter. So recycling biodegradable waste, so we'll talk about it now. So biodegradable waste can be recycled by the method of composting. This is one of the oldest form of disposal. Okay? It is a natural process that recycles the nutrient in the waste to yield the manure or compost. Nutrient हमें कैसे मिलता है? जो soil में bacterias हैं, वो इस जो भी raw vegetables हमारे पास हैं, उसको छोटे-छोटे parts में break कर देंगे. और जिसको वो छोटे-छोटे parts में break कर रहे हैं, तो हमें उसमें से nutrient मिलता है और वो nutrient soil में mix हो जाता है. Got it? So it becomes manure. It ensures that the waste is not carelessly thrown and left to decay. The manure obtained is very rich in nutrients and is an excellent medium for growing plants. Apart from being clean, cheap and safe, composting also reduces the amount of disposable garbage. So it is clean. It is very cheap. It does not require any money or something like that. It is safe also, and it reduces the disposable of garbage. So I think you got this point. Now coming on to the next type of composting, that is vermicomposting. Children, this is also very important. Procedure is same. जो हम कंपोस्टिंग में करते हैं वही हम वर्मी कंपोस्टिंग में करते हैं. सिर्फ डिफरेंस ये होता है कि इसमें हम एक्स्ट्रा एडिशनल अर्थवॉर्म, अर्थवॉर्म इन हिंदी इट इज कॉल्ड केचुआ. सो दिस अर्थवॉर्म बेसिकली रेड वॉर्म, वी जस्ट स्प्रिंकल इट और वी जस्ट थ्रो इट इन द दैट एरिया. ओके, दैट इज वर्मी कंपोस्टिंग. व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस रेड वॉर्म, व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस अर्थवॉर्म, children, earthworm is called farmer's friend. Got it? Earthworm is called farmer's friend. Why it is called farmer's friend? Because it helps or speed up in the process of composting, and the farmers are using it repeatedly. Okay, let's see what is vermicomposting. Let's discuss about vermicomposting. I'll show you the figures also. So let's see. Okay, now coming on to vermicomposting. Vermi naam kyun diya gaya hai? Kyunki we are talking about worms. Okay, so that is why it is given the name vermicomposting. Composting is the same process. Vermi isliye add kiya gaya kyunki hum isme worm use kar rahe hain. Got it? So let's see. It is the end product of breakdown of organic matter by some species of earthworm, especially we have red worms. Okay? सो ऑर्गेनिक मैटर का मतलब होता है जितने भी हमें एनिमल से प्रोडक्ट मिल रहे हैं, जैसे कि वेजिटेबल्स और फ्रूट्स एंड लीफी वेजिटेबल्स, और वी टॉक अबाउट चिकन और फ्लैश और एनीथिंग, दे आर कॉल्ड ऑर्गेनिक मैटर. ठीक, तो जब हम इन ऑर्गेनिक मैटर को ब्रेक डाउन करते हैं और इससे जो हमें एंड प्रोडक्ट मिलता है विद द हेल्प ऑफ, वी आर ब्रेकिंग इट डाउन विद द हेल्प ऑफ अर्थवॉर्म, दैट इज कॉल्ड कंपोस्ट. ओके, it is rich in nutrient and organic fertilizers. Got it? So let's see how we can, first we'll see what is the role of red worm in vermicomposting, then we'll go to a stepwise process how vermicomposting is done. So what is the role of red worm? Children, see, you can see in the figure, these are the red worms. Okay, these are the red worms or earthworm type. It is a species of earthworm. So let's see, worms break down the organic waste. Organic waste yani jo bhi humne vegetables ya plants ya fruits jo bhi dala hai usko break down karta hai ye worm. Okay, their excreta enriches the compost with nutrient. Excreta matlab jo bhi wo log excrete out kar rahe hain, जो भी ब्रेक डाउन करने के बाद वो excrete out कर रहे हैं, it is rich in nutrient and that helps the nutrient to mix with soil. Got it? So this is the role of red worm in vermicomposting. Then we have following steps by which vermicomposting can be formed. So first step is dig a pit of suitable size. हमने एक pit dig किया, pit यानी कि गड्ढा किया soil में. Spread a sand in it. हमने उसमें sand को spread किया. Add vegetables, plant और fruit waste, हमने उसमें सारे जितने भी हमारे पास organic waste हमने उसमें डाल दिए. Wet the layer by sprinkling water, हमने उसपे water से sprinkle कर दिया. Then we are placing the red worm, हमने red worm लिया and we placed it over that area. Got it? Then again उसके ऊपर हमने क्या किया, हमने उसको top and toss किया, and after top and tossing what we can do is we again will place the vegetable and fruit वेस्ट अलॉन्ग विद द रिमेन्स ऑफ टी. जितनी भी चीज हमारे किचन के डस्टबिन में है हम सब उसको डंप कर सकते हैं. ठीक है, इवन द शेल्स ऑफ एग वी कैन डंप इट. ओके, कवर विद अ ओल्ड शीट ऑफ क्लॉथ, हमने उसको क्लॉथ से कवर कर दिया. गॉट इट? लीव इट फॉर 3 to 4 weeks टू ऑब्टेन अ वर्मी कंपोस्ट. तो वर्मी कंपोस्ट ऑब्टेन करने के लिए हमें उसको इतने दिन के लिए रखना पड़ेगा. सो दीज आर द स्टेप्स टू फॉर्म वर्मी कंपोस्ट. एंड there are certain precautions we should take like plastic coated paper should not be used, excessive water should be avoided, keep the layers loose for aeration. हमें बहुत ज़्यादा tight नहीं रखना है उसको, उसको थोड़ा थोड़ा छोड़ देंगे ताकि उसमें से air pass हो सके. Do not use waste like milk, spices, salt, vinegar, pickles, etc. इसको नहीं use करना है क्योंकि वो bacteria को उसमें और grow कर देगा और वर्मी कंपोस्टिंग की process नहीं हो पाएगी. So these are the few steps and processes that are used in the vermicomposting. Children, it is mentioned in your book also in the activity, this activity 3. So this is your homework, children. Please read this activity 3. You will understand how we can make the vermicompost. Got it? So we have talked about the composting, we have talked about segregation of waste, we have talked about recycling of biodegradable waste by the process of composting and vermicomposting. Got it? So that was all about today's class. Children, if you have any kind of doubt, you can ask in the, again, we have a, which class? We have Zoom class. Alright, so we have an interactive class. You can ask your doubt in this, in that class. Alright, so we'll meet again. So that's all for today's class. Thank you and Jai Hind, children.